So tonight, the main event rematch, Cesaro versus Brock Lesnar. Randy Orton would win a match, and Brock Lesnar would be drafted to Friday Night SmackDown. Triple H would announce that he would be ineligible for his rematch and he could not face Cesaro for the title. The match would in fact become a non-title match. Brock Lesnar would absolutely lose it. He would take apart the table at ringside, deliver one of three F5s to Cesaro, and left Cesaro laid out in the middle of the ring. When Brock Lesnar was done with his prey, he would leave the ring, which would allow an opportunity for the returning Daniel Bryan, the former Money in the Bank holder, who was taken out via Cesaro. Daniel Bryan had his opportunity to go to WrestleMania. Cesaro would take him out, which would allow Cesaro to go on Extreme Rules to win his title. Bryan gets that retribution, hits the B plus knee, and cashed in for a 1-2-3 to claim the World Heavyweight Championship. Hello and welcome to Monday Night Raw. My name, of course, is Tubby Emu. What an action-packed show we have for you. And starting off, Cesaro and Triple H, who are currently in the ring. So Cesaro starts off the pay-per-view in the ring with Triple H, and he is calling out Daniel Bryan. He says Triple H and him have a challenge for him, as out comes Daniel Bryan, the new WWE World Heavyweight Champion. What is Daniel Bryan gonna say? He's asking Cesaro what he has in mind. He says last week that he beat him for the title and he couldn't be happier to be the new WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Triple H and Cesaro say tonight find a tag team partner, because the main event will be Cesaro and Triple H taking on Daniel Bryan and a partner to be named. And Daniel Bryan has accepted the fighting champion. He'll find a tag team partner and he'll get his hands on Triple H and Cesaro. That match is our main event and will happen later on tonight. But to start off the pay-per-view, Sheamus with his U.S. Open Challenge. So here we go. Who is going to answer? Sammy, NXT superstar Sami Zayn, has claimed the opportunity here tonight. Sami Zayn is in the hunt for another title on WWE NXT. In the first round of the NXT title, after Adrian Neville was stripped from being called up to the main roster, Hideo Itami would hit a stop, make one rookie move. Sami Zayn would capitalize, and he would hit the Haluva kick from the corner and get that 1-2-3. To move on, he will face Rhino this week on NXT. So what would this mean? He's already in the hunt for the NXT title. Getting a victory over Sheamus here tonight, would a U.S. champion then be able to go defend that title on NXT? We're going to have to wait and find out. What a coup this would be for NXT if they were able to come up and capture a title on his first night here in the WWE. Sheamus versus Sami Zayn. That match happens next. So here we go. Sheamus taking on Sami Zayn. What an opportunity this is for the young gun. Sami Zayn has wrestled all around the world. He is a world traveler. He will face Rhino this Wednesday on WWE NXT. What a match he would have with Hideo Itami. He would come up a little bit short. Also in that NXT tournament, winning a first-round matchup was Kevin Owens. What a matchup that could possibly be if Sami Zayn was to go up against Kevin Owens. But one of the things that we've kind of known, as Adrian Neville made his debut a few weeks ago, he would be stripped of that NXT title. Adrian Neville would choose to stay here on Monday Night Raw. If Sami Zayn were to win here tonight, would that mean he's automatically on the main roster? Does that move him up? Will he go back to NXT? Will he drop the title? Which title would be more important to him? As Sami Zayn has Sheamus reeling early on in the match, standing SummerSlam flip as Sheamus. I don't think Sheamus was expecting this. Last week, Sheamus defended in an open challenge against Goldust. Goldust would be looking to win the match, and right as he hit his finisher, Cody Rhodes would come out. Cody Rhodes would hit his crossroads. Sheamus would roll into the pin and successfully defend his title. As Sheamus gets taken out of the mat by Sami Zayn. Now, one thing that we want to say that's the same thing for both of these superstars. Both of these superstars have been in the title hunt before. Sami Zayn facing Adrian Neville, Sheamus being a former World Heavyweight Champion, a former United States Champion, a former Intercontinental Champion. Sheamus has done it all here in Universe Mode. As Sami Zayn gets out of the way, dropping Sheamus to the ground with that nice dropkick. Going after him, boots to asses. Are one of these guys going to face The Rock in Universe Mode? You're going to have to wait and find out. As Sheamus, one of the things that Sheamus said that he wanted to defend this title, that he was open to being in a match one-on-one, that he didn't need anything special, that he could face anybody and everybody, that he could defend his title. He knew he had the power of the brogue kick behind him. That brogue kick has taken out so many superstars. At Extreme Rules, he would face Rob Van Dam. Rob Van Dam was brought back to the WWE. We thought he was going to be a possible contender for the WWE World Heavyweight title, but Triple H pretty much just led him into an ambush. He would get eliminated in that six-man battle royale. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, go back and check out season number one. Sheamus would face him at the pay-per-view, and RVD would lose. Now, some of us thought RVD would still get an opportunity to face Sheamus. We thought this rivalry would continue. However, RVD last week was drafted over to Friday Night SmackDown. And by doing that, by being drafted away, or being drafted to Raw, excuse me, Sheamus being a SmackDown superstar, technically, not sure why he's defending here on Raw, he would have a beef with another superstar, possibly, as Sheamus. Excuse me. I'm Mago Cole there as he goes, stalking him. Now Sheamus going up top. Sami Zayn, was that the rookie mistake that he made? Is Sheamus going to capitalize? Sheamus up top. Big axe handle from the corner. Sheamus could be looking to finish this off right here. Is that one little mistake going to cost Sami Zayn his opportunity? Either way, if Sami Zayn loses this match, Sami has an opportunity at that NXT title. Standing in his path, like we said, Rhino, Kevin Owens, and another superstar that I think we're going to have some information on later tonight. As Sheamus dropping down. Sheamus waiting. Grabbing him from behind. Smashing him down on that knee. I think Sheamus realizes he's in control now. As you can see, he's stocking. Possibly setting up for the bro kick there. Sheamus going to the corner. But Sami Zayn wisely rolling out of the way. Sheamus trying to set up for a bro kick. No. Sami Zayn able to stop it. He scouted that big kick. I think Sami Zayn knows a little thing or two about a big kick with his Haluva kick. As you can see, another standing flip as Sami Zayn is in control. I don't think Sheamus was expecting this here tonight. And so far, Sami Zayn is making a case for why he should be the U.S. champion. As Sami Zayn stalking Sheamus, waiting for Sheamus to get back to his feet, setting him up. Middle of the ring, Blue Thunderbomb. Do we have a new champion? 1, 2. Sheamus kicks out at 2.9. That could have been it with that Blue Thunderbomb out of nowhere. I thought for a second there we had a new champion, but Sheamus was able to power out. Sami Zayn possibly looking to put him in the corner for the Helluva kick, but no, Sheamus able to take him down to the mat. Now Sheamus going for the pin. One. No, Sami Zayn able to power out at the count of one. Sheamus with a big hit. He bounces off the ropes. He catches him right into it. Irish curse backbreaker. Down goes Sami Zayn. And I think Sheamus knows it's over. Sheamus is calling for the brogue kick. Brogue. 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 But no, look at Sami. Sami wisely rolling out of the way. Sami knew it's coming. Sheamus taking him down to the mat with a big kick. Sami Zayn knew a brogue kick was coming. I think, is Sheamus going to try to go for something else in his arsenal? Wait a minute. Sami Zayn puts Sheamus in the corner. Sami Zayn. Helluva kick. Helluva kick. I don't think Sheamus was expecting this. One, two, three. We have a new U.S. champion. We have a new U.S. Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn debuted on Monday Night Raw. Came out of nowhere. He's in an NXT tournament for the title. What happens now? He is facing Rhino this week on NXT. Does Rhino automatically advance? Is it going to be Rhino versus Kevin Owens at the pay-per-view? Is Sami Zayn going to stay? What happens now as Sami Zayn has captured the U.S. title on Monday Night Raw? What a hell of a debut. As the bro kick, Sami knew the bro kick was coming. Sami got out of the way, and there he is, your brand new United States champion, Sami Zayn. What a huge victory, a huge coup for NXT. Is this the start of the NXT Wars on Monday Night Raw? Congratulations, kid, as Sami Zayn comes in and does the impossible. What does this mean for Sheamus? When is Sheamus going to get his rematch? We'll find out. Well, there is Dolph Ziggler, the man. He's been trying to get his hands on Triple... Wait a minute. There's Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan is offering Dolph Ziggler the opportunity to get his retribution on Triple H. And yes, Daniel Bryan has accepted. The tag team main event tonight will be Dolph Ziggler and Daniel Bryan taking on the team of Triple H and Cesaro. Yes, it is official. So we have our main event. Dolph Ziggler finally gets his hands on Triple H here tonight. So here we go with some Divas action. Paige got drafted over to Monday Night Raw. Tamina Snuka would face AJ Lee week number one. She would put up a hell of a fight, but in the end, it would take a second Shining Wizard. Tamina would fall to AJ Lee over on Friday Night SmackDown because the fact she was drafted over. Tamina would take on Paige. Tamina would catch her out of nowhere with a what some are calling a new finisher. And now Paige demanded a rematch tonight. So the winner of this match could possibly be the number one contender for the Divas title as Paige sends Tamina flying over the top rope. A huge opportunity for one of these Divas as Paige running, taking down Tamina on the outside as Paige is on a roll to start this match off. As Tamina, a fiery side of Tamina. I don't think we saw this side of Tamina in a very, very long time. Since she's came back here to the WWE after being taken out via injury, she has had a vicious streak to her. She says she wants the Divas title and she will do whatever it takes to capture that title. And here tonight, a win over Paige would cement her opportunity as the number one contender. As you can see, waiting for Paige to get back into the ring, taking her down with a big kick. Paige, on the upper hand, also coming back to the WWE, was taken out by the Bella Twins. The Bellas would go on to face AJ Lee. Both of them would fall into pay-per-view. Brie Bella and Nikki Bella had a little bit of dissent. Brie Bella tried to come in for the save, but she let her sister get pinned 1-2-3. If you missed the Extreme Rules pay-per-view, you can watch it. Twitch.tv/TubbyEmu. As Paige, waiting, going up top. Paige, big move from the top, hits the axe handle. Drop kick to the back of Tamina. Paige is on a little bit of a roll here, but Tamina quickly stopping it. Wait a minute. Paige out of nowhere. The Paige turn. The Paige turn. Is it over? Paige is your number one contender. One, two. No, Tamina is able to power out at two. So the fight at Tamina continues to roll on. As you can see, Tamina wants this bad. Tamina has never held a WWE title. She has never held the Divas title. She's never had an NXT title. There has been no title in the grasp. She has been the second fiddle, so to speak, for AJ Lee. She was AJ Lee's heavy. She came in and she was working with other Divas, but her solo career really hasn't taken off as Paige trying to steal the fire open. One, no, not even able to get a one. Tamina powers out there as Paige trying to stalk Tamina, getting a win over her. Now, if AJ Lee gives one of these Divas the opportunity at WWE Payback, it would be a huge Divas match because both of these Divas have had a victory over AJ Lee in the past, and the big thing was the title was never on the line. When the title's on the line, AJ Lee is just a different person. AJ Lee has held this title now in the Divas division for over 6 months. She's taken down the likes of the Bellas. She's taken down Naomi. She's taken down, does the list need to go on? Nobody's been able to dethrone her. Not even the Bellas, who the Bellas held the title as well for 6 months, as she actually took the belt from Nikki Bella. As you can see, Paige in the corner, big elbows, going after Tamina, pushing her off. Paige running, big knee from the corner. Paige going for the pin. This could be it. A new number one contender. One. No, powering out at one. Now, it'd be a little interesting here. If this is the true defining number one contenders match, if Paige were to get this victory, Tamina still technically has a victory over Paige. Wouldn't that not make it 1-1? Would that not make it, as you can see, the viciousness of Paige? Look at her. As Paige letting out a huge scream to let people know. I think even if Paige was to win this match, Tamina's got a case to be possibly a number one contender. She put up a good showing against AJ Lee as going up top, goes for a move. She hits off the rope, but I think Paige came down wrong. Paige came down a little bit wrong, and Tamina is capitalizing. Tamina trying to take advantage. Paige caught her. She would go off the rope. She rebounded nicely, but I think Paige may have injured her knee. Tamina's looking to finish it off. We know what's coming next. If she hits this, it is over. Tamina sending her down to the mat. One mistake is going to cost Paige her opportunity. It is going to be Tamina taking on AJ Lee at WWE Payback. The former heavy for AJ Lee is getting her opportunity. She's going to finally get that opportunity. No! Paige! Paige gets out of the way. From a super fly, oh my gosh, Paige She's got her up. The former heavy to AJ Lee. I don't think she's going to get that title opportunity just yet. She's still got to earn it as Paige. One, two, three. One small mistake by Paige, and then another by Tamina Snuka allows Paige to get the victory. And your new number one contender for the Divas title, Paige, here on Monday Night Raw. But I think this is far from over as Divas action here in the WWE is picked up. As they say, business is about to pick up here, King. And there it is, docking her from the corner. That was Tamina's one of her best shots to win the match. As she goes for it, Paige is able to power out. Big knee to the corner. But in the end, Paige is now your number one contender. So at WWE Payback, it is going to be a good one. We have got Paige taking on AJ Lee for the Divas title. A year in the making after Paige debuted, won the title away from her. Paige would go on to face Nikki Bella, drop the title to Nikki Bella. Nikki Bella would go on to lose to AJ Lee. Things are coming full circle. A year later, will she get her opportunity? Backstage, Sheamus is complaining about the fact that an NXT superstar was allowed to challenge him, and he is demanding Triple H make it right. Triple H and Sheamus have kind of had a little bit of a relationship. Are we going to see some favorites being played as Sheamus is demanding something? Not exactly sure what he's demanding, but he's telling Triple H something. And Triple H, I think, has agreed with him. And Sheamus walks away happy. So what does that mean? Is he getting his rematch? We're going to find out. So here we go, Rob Van Dam taking on Bad News Barrett. Bad News Barrett has been in a little bit of a slump lately. Hasn't really done anything. RVD catch him out of nowhere. BNB has said he's been getting screwed as of late, that every opportunity that comes up, he has been held down, that he is waiting for his breakout moment, that everybody has purposely prevented him from being a star here in the WWE, and he is trying to make that right. An opportunity here. If he was to get a win over RVD, it'd be a big win here on Monday Night Raw, Mr. Rob Van Dam, Mr. Monday Night. It'd be one of the bigger things I think BNB has done of late, because so far he's been getting screwed left and right. At least he feels in his mind that he has been getting screwed left and right. Another superstar I think has been getting screwed left and right is Rob Van Dam. Rob Van Dam brought back to the WWE. He would face off in a big six-man battle royale. We would welcome him back. He would go on to pretty much get set up by Triple H. Triple H just brought him to feed his ego. Triple H would go on to win that battle royale match. He would use Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler was used to take out how many superstars in the last couple months? Dolph Ziggler would eliminate Rob Van Dam, and then Triple H would eliminate Dolph Ziggler. Rob Van Dam looking to get something going. He would face Sheamus at a pay-per-view in a Falls Count Anywhere match, impromptu announced, last minute on the pay-per-view pre-show, which you guys can watch, twitch.tv /TubbyEmu, but he would lose the match as Rob Van Dam tries to get something going. Trying to steal one via roll-up pin here. One. No, he's able to kick out at one. I'd have to imagine that either one of these superstars could possibly do something big here. It's coming up with the Payback pay-per-view. Bad news, Barrett. Who is he going to get payback on? Who is BNP possibly looking to take out? Because so far, if we were to look at his past, people that he's faced, he's got a long list of people that have done him dirty. Is Rob Van Dam setting him up, throwing him off the ropes, jumping overneath him. Wait, Rob Van Dam, what are you doing? Rob Van Dam, I think he was trying to do something. He gets out of the ring, taking down BNP. As Rob Van Dam possibly setting up for the finish here? No. BNP able to get back to his feet, laying a shot to Rob Van Dam in the corner. Finally, BNP takes him down to the mat. RVD. Uh-oh. Winds of change out of nowhere. RVD gets taken down to the winds of change. This could be it. One. Two. No, not able to get a two count as Rob Van Dam was able to kick out. Mr. Monday Night looks to get a victory here on Monday Night. As he gets out of the way. Rob Van Dam. Big running knee to the back of Wade Barrett. He's setting him up. He could be going for it right here. From the corner. Setting him up. Five-star frog splash. It is over. Rob Van Dam. One. Two. No. Bad news. Barrett just kicked out. Bad news. Barrett after weeks of getting... Rob Van Dam cannot believe what is going on right now. Rob Van Dam cannot believe that BNB just kicked out of that. After weeks of getting screwed, is this a new, more vicious, wicked BNB? He just kicked out of a man's finisher that has put down the likes of John Cena, Kurt Angle, Triple H, many, many other superstars. Is Rob Van Dam. I think Rob Van Dam's a little befuddled here. He doesn't really know what to do. Rolling Thunder connects. As he's going for the pin right here on him. One, two, no. Able to power out again. BNB showing a little bit of something special here. BNB taking a beating, and still, he's still going. He's still powering through here as he's trying to take RVD out. He's picking RVD up. Big slam down to the mat goes Rob Van Dam. As BNB in control, getting down, pummeling him. I think he's saying something to him. I can't exactly hear what he's saying. But he's picking him up right now. RVD. Able to counter, RVD face first, goes down to the mat of BNB. Like we said, this side of BNB doesn't come out very often. We haven't really seen it as Rob Van Dam going up top once again. Rob, I don't know how smart this is. This is twice now he was caught. Rob Van Dam, I think, is flustered here. He's not sure what exactly is going on. Hits the big running kick. I think BNB and Rob Van Dam are getting caught off guard here. Big move from Wade Barrett. This could be it. One. Two, no, Rob Van Dam able to power out there. Huge move from Wade Barrett, but not able to keep him down. Rob Van Dam reverses it. Hits him. Wade Barrett reverses it. Wade Barrett going for a bullhammer, winds of change, but he stopped it. Rob Van Dam now goes to grab BNB, but once again the reversal sequences. Both of these men know each other so well, apparently. Finally, BNB takes down Rob Van Dam to the mat. This could be it. Going for the pin. One. Powers out at two. Rob Van Dam. BNB putting on a clinic here on Monday Night Raw. As both men know each other so well. Rob fighting out. Putting him in the corner. What is he possibly setting up for? As BNB going for the pin after Rob Van Dam buckled off there, but no rope break. BNB could have had a victory there, but a rope break. Now a big kick to the midsection. Rob Van Dam gets out of the way. Wait a minute. Rob Van Dam. His foot's on the rope. His foot's on the rope. Three. His foot was on the rope. Did the referee not see? His foot was on the rope. Rob Van Dam just scored the roll-up pin to get a huge victory here, Mr. Monday Night. But you can see Wade Barrett's foot was clearly on the rope. No wonder BNB has thought he's been getting screwed as of late as Mr. Monday Night picks up a victory. He'll take it. A win is a win, according to RVD. So BNB, the screw jobs continue. As announced on Friday Night SmackDown, Brock Lesnar versus Randy Orton at WWE Payback.
feel lucky. I feel great. It's time to go to work.
So as we get going, this is a, what the hell is Sheamus doing out here? Sheamus losing earlier on in the night to Sami Zayn for the U.S. title. Is this what he was talking to Triple H about? A six-man over-the-top battle royale for the IC title. It looks like Sheamus has weaseled his way into this match. Who is the sixth guy? Who would it? It's an NXT superstar. Who is it? Tyler Breeze has made his debut here on Monday Night Raw. Let's take you back. Tyler Breeze winning his first round matchup. He will face Kevin Owens. Out of nowhere, the big super kick from Tyler Breeze on Finn Balor at NXT. He would get the victory. Finn's hand looked like it was under the rope. The referee still counted the three count. As this Wednesday on NXT, Kevin Owens versus Tyler Breeze, and Sami Zayn will take on Rhino. So here we go. An NXT superstar has already debuted and won the U.S. title. Is Tyler Breeze going to debut here tonight? Is Adrian Neville goes after Sheamus right away? Why the hell Sheamus is in this match, I have no idea. Sheamus and Triple H playing buddy-buddy. Sheamus going to Triple H. Demanding something. They agreed on it. Sheamus getting put in this match. And right away, John Cena going after Tyler Breeze. The crowd is absolutely booing. They're going insane right now. If John Cena eliminates Tyler Breeze, thanks for coming, NXT rookie. Coming all the way up here tonight to get eliminated by John Cena. But no, Tyler Breeze holds on. On the other side, Rusev going after Kofi Kingston, and already Kofi Kingston has been eliminated. Rusev taking him out. As Sheamus going after Neville. They're going after the biggest dog in the yard. Tyler Breeze trying to eliminate John Cena. What a huge coup that would be for NXT to not only hold the U.S. title, but to then be the number one contender to Tyson Kidd's IC Championship. His IC Championship that he beat Dolph Ziggler for at a TLC match at Extreme Rules. He would face off Dolph Ziggler the very next night in a rematch. Triple H would get involved, cost Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler wanting to get his hands on Triple H for that. And now John Cena still fighting out. As if Tyler Breeze was going to eliminate John Cena here, the internet would break. Prince Pretty trying to take him out. Now Sheamus is teaming up with him. Sheamus and Tyler Breeze trying to work together to take out John Cena, but John Cena fighting out of it. Now John Cena going back after Tyler Breeze. But once again, Tyler Breeze sending John Cena over the top. I don't think Cena was expecting this here tonight. A fight, a game. Tyler Breeze, his NXT superstars are coming up, balls to the wall. First Sheamus, now could it be John Cena getting taken out? The two biggest names possibly in the WWE as of late getting taken out by NXT superstars. And this could possibly be the start of an invasion for all we know. As Adrian Neville also in this match, a former NXT superstar, along with Rusev. As Tyler Breeze trying to go after Adrian Neville there. I think he was going to go after Cena. He realizes he couldn't get Cena. Now he's going after Adrian Neville. And now Cena and Tyler Breeze are pairing up to go against Neville. Tyler Breeze, I don't think he's too happy that Neville debuted before him. As Adrian Neville gets taken out. Adrian Neville would debut. He would get stripped of that NXT title. That is why Tyler Breeze is facing Kevin Owens this week on WWE NXT. It was because of the fact that Adrian Neville is up here in matches like this. And now Tyler Breeze once again trying to eliminate John Cena, trying to take out the biggest dog on the yard, trying to make a name for himself. As John Cena saying, to Kevin Matumbo, no. He stops him, trying to keep him from it. As Sheamus going after John Cena now. Things are starting to spice up a little bit as Rusev going after Tyler Breeze. Tyler Breeze taking him down to the mat now. Sheamus has gotten John Cena up. White Noise gets taken down to the White Noise. Now Rusev throwing Tyler Breeze into the ropes, throwing him over. Look at the strength and the power of Rusev here. John Cena, though, out of nowhere. Attitude adjustment on Sheamus. Now Rusev. Rusev, is he about to be eliminated by John Cena? Setting him over the top. Cena trying to eliminate Rusev. He's got one. Trying to hit the second one. Is he going to be able to eliminate him? Sheamus and Tyler Breeze, I think they realize that John Cena is the biggest dog in the yard. Trying to work out a plan. To take out Cena. Both men now trying to go after, but no, Rusev is going to stop it. Rusev takes out Sheamus. That could have been the opportunity they needed. Now both men turn to John Cena. Even Rusev realizes that they have to take out Cena first. Cena, this is like a 3-on-1. Cena, is he going to be able to overcome? Rusev hits a big move. Cena in the corner. Tyler Breeze able to get out of the way. So much action going on in this match. Cena fights out. Cena going for a clothesline, but no, gets out of the way. Sheamus taking down Rusev. Tyler Breeze once again setting John Cena over the top rope. Tyler Breeze, this could be it. How many times is he going to try to eliminate Cena? I don't think the fans can handle this. The fans are losing their shit here tonight as the boos, the cheers keeps going on. Is now Sheamus going after Tyler Breeze. I think the alliance has turned. They realize that Cena's going to be in this match a while. If anybody can get eliminated. Cena now setting Rusev over the top. Cena trying to eliminate Rusev as Tyler Breeze and Sheamus are brawling. He's going to do it. John Cena has eliminated Rusev. Rusev is out. Tyler Breeze, Sheamus, and John Cena. John Cena, the reason he is in this match is because he demanded an opportunity. I mean, Tyler Breeze, the crowd has just turned Sheamus with the biggest heel move he could do, eliminating the NXT superstar. Tyler Breeze, what a debut here tonight, though. He will face Kevin Owens at NXT. So it was John Cena versus Brock Lesnar at Extreme Rules. They would beat the absolute hell out of each other. Cesaro would come out mid-match. He would win the match. John Cena never fairly had a shake. He didn't get pinned. John Cena had a legitimate claim to fight for the World Heavyweight Championship against Cesaro. Triple H said no. He said if you want to fight for a title, you'll fight for the IC title. Are we hearing cheers for John Cena? Sheamus pulled the biggest heel move and eliminated Tyler Breeze. He took out Prince Pretty. And now the crowd is actually cheering for John Cena to take out Sheamus. Got him up top. John Cena has done it. Cena has eliminated Sheamus. And your number one contender for Tyson Kidd's Intercontinental Championship is John Cena. Never give up. But still, one hell of a debut here for Prince Pretty. As John Cena taking two attitude adjustments to clear Sheamus. And it seems like the crowd is kind of on his side. That's what you get when you take out a guy like Sheamus, who's playing buddy-buddy with the Authority. So a WWE payback, John Cena will take on Tyson Kidd for the IC title. What is going to happen next as Monday Night Raw rolls on? So still more wrestling action to happen here tonight, but in our main event, it'll be Triple H and Cesaro taking on Dolph Ziggler and Daniel Bryan. Dolph Ziggler finally gets his opportunity at Triple H. So here we go. Cody Rhodes taking on Tyson Kidd. Cody Rhodes last week. Constantly trying to get a roll-up pin on the IC champion. We already have a new number one contender. That would be Tyson Kidd versus John Cena at the WWE Payback pay-per-view. Kicking out at 2.9, but a win over Cody Rhodes here would be huge and could possibly set him up for a future Intercontinental Championship opportunity. Him and his brother have been feuding for quite some time now. Leading up to the Extreme Rules pay-per-view, they were former tag team champions. At WrestleMania, they would lose. They would go to get the rematch against the Usos, and Goldust would turn on Cody. They would try to reteam the very next week. Cody then would turn on Goldust. This would lead to a match where Goldust would kick his brother in the nads. They would face off on pay-per-view, in which Goldust would get a hard-fought victory over Cody. And Cody Rhodes last week would cost Goldust his shot at the United States Championship. As up top goes Cody Rhodes. Huge move. This could be it. Tyson Kidd able to power out at one. If you missed that episode last month, go ahead and check it out. What a huge, huge opportunity that was for Goldust. Goldust had the match won. He hit his finisher. It was over, but he was laid out by Cody Rhodes from behind with a crossroads, which would allow Sheamus to roll into the pin for the 1-2-3 as Cody Rhodes trying to make a name for himself. As Tyson Kidd, as the IC champion so far, he's faced Dolph Ziggler, beat him for the title, won his rematch, and a lot of people are speculating the only reason that Tyson Kidd is still the IC champion and not Dolph Ziggler is because of Triple H. Triple H has cost Dolph Ziggler on numerous occasions now. Everybody thought in season one that Dolph Ziggler was headed on a path to greatness. Dolph Ziggler was made to be, was basically made or perceived to look like the next big thing. He would face Mark Henry in a champion versus championship match. He would beat him in that match because of a distraction from Cesaro, which would cause Mark Henry to get injured. Mark Henry would then go on to get kicked by the Usos and being taken out of the pay-per-view. Then Dolph Ziggler was used to take out Rob Van Dam. Dolph Ziggler has kind of been used by Triple H to take out the superstars that he doesn't like. But still, Dolph Ziggler's opportunity has been getting taken away wayside after wayside after wayside. And now Tyson Kidd is your IC champion, and he no longer has to worry about Dolph Ziggler getting his rematch because Dolph Ziggler's focus has turned elsewhere. Tyson Kidd, on the other hand, having to face John Cena is a huge worry for the young kid, and I can't imagine that Tyson Kidd is super excited about having to face John Cena. As Cody Rhodes trying to stalk Tyson Kidd, like we said, this would be a huge opportunity for Cody Rhodes. As we've already seen what Tyson has done as champion, he's needed other superstars to possibly retain his title. But going for a figure four there, going to try to get him to tap out. Tyson Kidd with his signature move, his signature hold, trying to get him to tap out. Is he going to get him to tap out? He's got it wrenched in. And no, Cody Rhodes is able to break out of it. Cody Rhodes still going strong as Tyson Kidd now takes him down to the mat. As trying to pick him up, going for a suplex. No, Cody stuffs it. Cody Rhodes with the suplex of his own, able to take down Tyson. Cody Rhodes, a former Intercontinental Champion. The title that Tyson Kidd holds is the one that Cody Rhodes brought back. Cody Rhodes would ditch the old IC title design. He would bring back this belt. He wanted a prominent title. Cody trying to regain that title that he so brought to the WWE. What a huge opportunity it was. 2 years later to recapture the title that you introduced. Huge opportunity for payback. As Cody tries to steal it once again by a roll-up pin, but no. Tyson Kidd's hand was under the rope. The referee calls a rope break. Cody trying to stack him, but Tyson Kidd stuffing it. Tyson Kidd picking him up. Suplex. Trying to roll into a cover now. One. No. Cody Rhodes able to power out at one. As you can see, Tyson Kidd so far his IC title as champion has faced the likes of Dolph Ziggler. And Dolph Ziggler again the next week. But I don't think he's faced a caliber of talent like John Cena. So getting a win over Cody Rhodes here, who in the past may have caught a lucky break over Cena once or twice, would be huge. Get a little bit of momentum going into his match with John Cena at Payback. Putting him in the corner, Tyson Kidd. What is he doing? He's trying to set up for something. As I think Cody was supposed to do something, but Cody Rhodes running out of the way. Cody Rhodes running off the ropes. Cody bouncing back. A little bit of this. I don't think they really knew what was going on there. Trying to steal one via roll-up pin again. Cody trying to get a win any way possible. Now Tyson Kidd rolls over. One, two. No, he's able to kick out at 2.9. We thought Tyson was going to be able to steal one. As Tyson Kidd stalking Cody Rhodes, waiting for him to get up. Tyson Kidd trying to hit something, going for a big move, but Cody stuffed it. Cody stuffed it. Tyson stuffed it. A back and forth. Cody once again stuffs it, puts him in the corner. Cody Rhodes going up top with Tyson Kidd, trying to lay some big shots on him. And here he goes. He's got him up. The muscle buster. The muscle buster on Tyson Kidd. As Cody Rhodes stalking him right now. Cody trying to hit his finisher. But Tyson Kidd rolls to the mat. He knew it was coming. Tyson Kidd stopped it. But Cody says, I don't think so. Cody goes for it again. Crossroads. But he's laid out. What the hell? Cody is crawling to the pin, but Goldust music plays. Cody's so confused. Cody doesn't know what's going on. He's looking around trying to find Goldust. Cody. I don't think Cody knows what's happening. He hit the crossroads. It was over. Cody won. Cody should possibly be facing Tyson Kidd in a future opportunity. But he gets the gold dust. I don't think these two are done just yet. Tyson Kidd fighting out of it. Tyson Kidd. Tyson Kidd trying to see over a roll pin. Tyson. One. Two. Three. Tyson Kidd steals one from Cody Rhodes thanks to a distraction from gold dust. So last week, Cody Rhodes hit his finisher. On Goldust, after Goldust hit his finisher here, Cody Rhodes hit his finisher. Goldust playing some mind games with the music, and in the end, Cody Rhodes falls to Tyson Kidd via roll-up pin. So still, things are not over between Cody Rhodes and Goldust. They look to possibly be headed against, and yes, I am being told now that these two will be facing off at WWE Payback, but still your Intercontinental Champion and headed on to possibly bigger and better things, Tyson Kidd. So big win for Tyson Kidd here. And unfortunately, Goldust and Cody Rhodes. Well, I don't want to say unfortunately. It's fortunate for us that we get to see these two go on, but as brothers, the dissension continues. As Tyson Kidd tells the referee to get out of his way, as Monday Night Raw rolls on, the main event is up next. So backstage, Sheamus talking with personnel, and Sheamus says that he wants his rematch. So next week, it'll be Sheamus taking on Sami Zayn thanks to Triple H. So how many opportunities is Sheamus going to get? First he loses, then he gets put into IC title. Now next week, he will face Sami Zayn in a rematch for the U.S. title. what the hell is going on? Where is Dolph Ziggler? We're being told Dolph Ziggler has been found backstage, taken out. Dolph Ziggler has been knocked out. So Dolph Ziggler was finally getting get his opportunity to get his hands on Triple H. He's conveniently laid out backstage. You have to imagine that the game Triple H was behind this. Triple H has absolutely tried to keep Dolph Ziggler down. And now Daniel Bryan will have to go up against these two. 1-on-2 in a handicap match. So here we go. How convenient for Triple H and Cesaro after Daniel Bryan wins the title last week. A tag match here tonight turns into a 2-on-1 handicap match as Dolph Ziggler gets taken out backstage. I wonder who had Dolph Ziggler taken out backstage. This conveniently helps Cesaro and Triple H as Daniel Bryan is rolling early on in the match. This is just despicable as Triple H is doing whatever. First, it started on Friday Night SmackDown when Triple H told Dolph Ziggler, "Dolph, if you want to face me, you're going to have to go through a series of matches." First, he had to go up against Big Show. He won in the main event. And then an ominous message would play on the board. Maybe some mind games. You're going to have to go watch that episode of SmackDown to find out what I'm talking about. But Triple H now taking down Daniel Bryan. The numbers game are going to have to come into play here. As Daniel Bryan, even as the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, you're going up against Triple H and Cesaro. I don't know if the numbers game... Okay, see, look at that. The numbers game are already coming into play as Triple H and Cesaro have kind of been the duo. The only reason that Triple H is the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, or the WWE Heavyweight Champion, excuse me, is because of Cesaro. Mark Henry was eliminated. It was going to be Cesaro versus Triple H. We all thought that Cesaro was just going to lay down for Triple H. Mark Henry would show up last minute. He would be involved in the triple threat match, which would see King Cesaro swing Mark Henry and then tell Triple H, go for the pin on him. He would pin Mark Henry. So Triple H pinned Mark Henry. Mark Henry would then, via injury, would be out. He wouldn't be able to compete, and we haven't seen Mark Henry since that pay-per-view. So now Dolph Ziggler, after everything he's gone through, is trying to get some retribution on Triple H. And Triple H, though, gets taken down. Daniel's trying to set up for a spine buster. Daniel Bryan, this early on in the match, he's trying to set up for a B-plus knee. Turn around, Daniel Bryan. B-plus knee on Triple H. B-plus knee. But look at the numbers game. Triple H is laid out of the ring. 1, 2, 3, 4. Triple H is out, but look at that. The numbers game. Cesaro, the match was over. Daniel Bryan just won. He hit the B-plus knee. The same B-plus knee he used at WrestleMania to take out Triple H now gets stuffed because of Cesaro. As Daniel Bryan sending Cesaro, just trying to scare him a little bit there, get him off the apron. Daniel Bryan running dropkick in the corner. Triple H getting pinned by Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan not able to get the pin at 1. Triple H kicks out. So you can see Triple H has something against Daniel Bryan. He's called him a vanilla midget before, a B-plus player. Said he didn't have what it takes. Daniel Bryan would return from injury after missing WrestleMania right in front of the face of Triple H trying to roll up Cesaro. 2.9. We thought Daniel Bryan might have been able to steal it right there. But he was able to kick out. Now he's got him in the corner. Big drop kick to Cesaro this time. Daniel Bryan trying to rally the crowd behind him. The crowd is going insane. But are the numbers game going to be too much as Cesaro hits a huge European uppercut? Another uppercut as Daniel Bryan falls off of the top turnbuckle. And Cesaro goes to hit it from the side. Taking down Daniel Bryan. Is that a gut wrench? I could not remember the name of that for a second. Daniel Bryan able to power out at 1. So this 2-on-1 impromptu handicap match, it should have been a tag team match, but Dolph Ziggler was taken out backstage. One can only assume that it was Triple H. as Daniel Bryan's got him for a yes lock, but Triple H isn't getting in to break it up as Cesaro seems to be in control. Cesaro said he's got it. Cesaro able to break out of it, though. Not sure how he broke out. Did he bite the refs? I'm not sure what he did. But Cesaro taking down Daniel Bryan. Now Cesaro continuing to go after Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan goes for a big kick, gets out of the way, but a big shot to the head there. Daniel Bryan could be stealing this one. Going for the pin. One. No, Cesaro able to kick out at one. As you can see there, from behind, big German suplex laying Daniel Bryan out on the mat. Now he's just rubbing his face in it. He's rubbing his face in the fact that Daniel Bryan's got nobody to tag. Cesaro's got a fresh man, Triple H, in the corner. Daniel Bryan's got nobody. Another huge European uppercut. How many European uppercuts will it take to keep Daniel Bryan down? Daniel Bryan from behind. Grabbing Cesaro, taking him down. Trying to take out Triple H now. Laying Triple H out. Lays him out. Yes, yes. No, another European uppercut. One, two. Daniel Bryan able to kick out at two. Another European uppercut from Triple H. And then Cesaro, though, is able to capitalize. Throwing Daniel Bryan around. Just throwing him around here in this match. Going for the pin. This is going to be it. One. No, he's able to kick out at one. Triple H. I don't think Triple H necessarily wants to get in the ring with Daniel Bryan there. I think he wants Cesaro. Cesaro wants Daniel Bryan. He's telling Triple H to kind of stay out of it, then I'll take care of this. Triple, look at the numbers game again. Daniel Bryan, every time he tries to fight out of it, the numbers game come into play as Cesaro capitalizes, sending Daniel Bryan down to the mat. This is going to be it. One. No, Daniel Bryan powering out at one. Cesaro going after Daniel, trying to kick him. Come on, Daniel. Power up, fight out. Just keep. You can do this, kid. You can win. Cesaro laying some haymakers once again. Bridge suplex down to the mat. Daniel Bryan kicks out again. How much does Daniel Bryan have in the tank here? As Daniel Bryan running off the ropes. I think he's trying to set up for a B-plus knee, but he changes his mind. Yes lock. Yes lock again, but look where he was positioned, right against the ropes. And there's the numbers game again. The numbers game as Triple H comes in. Triple H had no reason to break that up. Daniel Bryan had that match in control as Cesaro. Cesaro with a kill shot from the corner, and that's going to do it. Daniel Bryan put up one hell of an opportunity, but Dolph Ziggler was not here tonight. Taken out backstage. So Triple H and Cesaro get the victory. Absolutely despicable. So after Daniel Bryan cashed in Money in the Bank last week, the new WWE World Heavyweight Champion was put into an ambush. Triple H granted a tag team match. He said, Daniel Bryan, go find a tag team partner. Daniel went to the predictable partner. He went to Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler conveniently taken out backstage. And now Daniel Bryan falls to both of these men. As you can see, a B-plus knee. There is no coincidence about it. As Daniel Bryan got screwed. The new champion got screwed. So when Cesaro and Daniel Bryan face off at WWE Payback, you can imagine Bryan wants some payback. Cesaro wants some payback for cashing in the title. But that'll kind of wrap things up as Cesaro gets the pin on Daniel Bryan. So Triple H and Cesaro sending a message to the locker room. Apparently that's what happens when you get in their way. Wait a damn, Mark Henry. Maybe it wasn't Triple H and Cesaro. Mark Henry was taken out by Dolph. He was taken out by Triple H and Cesaro. Is Mark Henry on a warpath? Mark Henry sending a message to Triple H and Cesaro. Thank you very much for joining us. Is Mark Henry playing some mind games? We will see you all next week.